And start here, since Jessie has to leave a little early, and I don't know if she wants to get part of it. Anyhow, just give a brief introduction here of Roger Noether, and as all of you know, Roger is the brother of Audrey Noether, and is one of several Noether children the families began summering here way back in 1962, which I just found out today.
Yeah, yeah.
And were summer residents for many, many years. His father was Hans Noether, who was pictured up there on the wall. And
third one.
Mother was Jerry Noether.
Hallie, and my mom was for your assistant benefit, at the school.
That's him right there. Can you see the resemblance to Roger? Yeah.
I should stand next to the
picture. But anyhow, Roger is a language expert in certain languages. And he's going to talk to us tonight about how to learn a language, so to speak. He has spent 5 years teaching under contract to the Department of Defense. Here's Audrey.
Good.
At the Defense Language Institute in Monterey, California, which I'm quite familiar with because when I was in San Francisco field office, I used to have to go down there quite often and do background investigations with some of these folks. So Roger has taught Chinese to a number of our military personnel there at the Defense Language Institute. And Chinese is considered a very, what they call, hard language as foreign languages go.
That means you get extra time to learn it.
That's
if
right.
You're in the military.
It's like Arabic, it's like Russian.
Yeah, right, the same category.
Yeah. And Roger has also spent approximately 4 years at Fort Bragg, North Carolina, again in the military environment. And I'm familiar with Fort Bragg too. My career took me there a little bit, so I know the environment.
That's where the Special Forces train.
That's right. Delta Force, Navy SEALs, the Rangers, all that.
Yeah,
could you clarify just a little bit what you were teaching there? I didn't quite pick
when,
it up.
When I was actually not teaching there. I was editing their teaching materials, and I was training the teachers, because what they do is they'll have native person come in under contract, and then they're not trained to teach. So they have proficiency in their native language, but they're not trained to teach. So I have to train them how to teach the soldiers. That was one of the things. And also, they would be in the classroom, they'd be teaching the language, and they don't know the English equivalent. And the soldiers don't understand the Chinese, so I'd have to translate in between.
Anyhow, that's all I have to say about Roger. And we better get him going here so that we don't rush out the door at 7. A couple of us have to.
Of people have to.
But
and
we do appreciate very much his volunteering time to come here and put on this lecture. And very, very well appreciated.
Okay, thank you, folks. And I want to do the best I can here for you. Okay, so the first thing is, I'm not in competition with my sister. Okay, she is teaching children in a school setting, which is pedagogy, and I was doing andragogy, which is teaching of adults, adult education. So two different fields of endeavor, kind of. So the teaching methods are different. You know, and I'm addressing everybody now. You can learn a foreign language, even though you're an adult, okay? That's what my message is to you, you know? So this is, I want you to take away this positive method. And I've seen it myself. I learned Chinese, I was 17. I just finished with high school. I took 1 year in high school, and I knew 3 characters at the end, and the whole thing was a failure. So, Karen, she just told everybody she learned English. She was, what, 40?
46.
My dad learned English. He was 28. He came from our town is Mannheim, and towards the south of Germany, Baden-Württemberg. And in the Weimar years, when my dad grew up, there was no English being taught. Nobody cared. They wanted to learn French. And that was more important to them at that point. So, okay, so now we go here. I want to start with the idea of motivation, okay? Because this is the most important thing. Not your accent, not the study technique, not anything like that, is motivation. Without motivation, you accomplish nothing, okay? With motivation, you're going to be okay, no matter what. So let's look at some of the motivating factors that people have. I just gave an example. Adult finds a job in a foreign country. I've seen engineers, IT guys from America, don't know any Chinese, but they got a nice job in Shanghai. Okay? So they go and pick up the offer and they go. I saw a very impressive video clip from a Chinese news program, and it was entitled Foreigners in China. And there's a young American woman, mid-30s, okay, Air Force pilot, okay, she could not find a civilian pilot job in the United States that was suitable for her. So the Chinese picked her up, regional airline, they trained her, gave her the text of the manual. She had to say, she had to recertify in China, although she was a U.S. Air Force pilot, retired. She had to recertify in China. They let her take the test in English. She certified. Okay, so now she's working in China, and she gets on the plane, and none of the passengers speak English. Maybe her co-pilot speaks some English. Maybe some of the stewardesses do, but, you know, and then there's the daily life aspect. And then on top of that, the woman is a single mom, has a daughter who's 16, 17. The daughter's coming to China to see what mom's environment is like, so mom has to take her to the store. Maybe the daughter wants new dress or something, altered it. You gotta speak Chinese. And so that's what happens. Okay, the spouse, the same thing. A lot of people get interested, let's say their kids go to college in the United States. They can't find a good job when they get out because they were liberal arts majors. So what do? They go and teach English, let's say in Thailand. So you go to Thailand and your mom and dad start getting interested. Gee, that's a fascinating culture. You know, what is it like there? And because my kid is in Bangkok, I want to go see it. And then hopefully the kid who's there teaching English learns some Thai and can take mom and dad around a bit. So that's one thing. Or people, probably this is your pastor here, Tom Powell's situation. They want to spread the gospel, do things with it, maybe do projects of public worth or charitable ventures there. So they have to learn a foreign language. Mormons especially, they do this because the way I understand it, they're like the Thai Buddhists, that all the Mormons go for 2 years on mission. Like the Thai guy, the men at least have to be monks for 1 or 2 years. I think same kind of concept. I understand it right. But, okay, so these are some of the motivating factors. Your military career. You have a military career, and I'm facetious, but I'm not facetious. You want to further, you've robbed a convenience store out at Bangor, and you find the United States Army's not going to take you. You got a problem. But you can join the French Foreign Legion. They'll take you, no problem. And they're not going to turn you over to the Bangor police, FBI, or anybody. As long as you serve in their military, you're fine. And at the end of the service, you become French citizen. You can have a nice home in a winery or something when you retire from the French Foreign Legion. They do this for you. Have I seen examples? Yeah, a report on NPR They went to Afghanistan. They're interviewing a guy. It's an American guy. He can't be in the American Armed Forces because he had a little problem with the law in America. But he was with the French, and it was nice for the NPR reporter because he spoke English. But of course, the guy with his military service, he better speak French. Okay, this is a big example. The foreign country comes to you. For our scenario, what happens if this Chinese investor comes to this cove and decides they want to start a sea urchin farm or something like that? And bingo, you have an enterprise set up here. You want to be part of that enterprise. You want to rise up in that enterprise. This happens in the South. The Chinese bought, everybody knows, like Smithfield ham. Okay, they went into Virginia, bought the whole business, you know. Smith, it's a Chinese, and it's a good deal for the United States from my point of view, because Americans then get to sell their pork to China in huge, and the Chinese come up, raise their level to the production level and to the quality level of the Smithfield ham. Okay, and of course this one is quite obvious. You're in love with your spouse and want to speak her language. Well, I'm still half in love maybe with my spouse, but I want to out-argue her in her own language. This is my motivation. I want to make my points. So this works for some people. So all kinds of, so now what do we do, folks? Well, we got no money for specialized Berlitz courses. You can look online how much that costs to go to the Berlitz Business School. It's for business people, usually quite pricey, if I remember. Okay, I can't go abroad. You can't just pack yourself up and say, I want to learn Spanish. I'm going to pack myself up and go to Madrid. Okay, I'm going to stay there a year and my Spanish will be good. Probably will, but the thing is, it takes a lot of money. And then you have an additional problem if you're an American. You can't work in Madrid. You need a work visa, and it's not going to happen very easily because they have an employment rate of 30%. So they're probably not going to give you a work visa. So you have that problem. Okay, my French textbooks, I could have said Spanish textbooks, were from school are really boring. They just bore the daylights out of me. And to make matters worse, they're filled with what we call, what's it called?
Conjugation.
Worse than that, drill to kill exercises. Drill to kill. Conjugate, all this stuff. Oh, that'll kill everybody. All at the same time. All right, next we have another problem. This is my fault. Cranberry Isles Library doesn't have the Rosetta Stone or Pimsleur. I promised to donate one, and then what happened to me, I had a change of heart because I found this material, which is far superior, okay? So we have this material instead, and that's why I'm not donating those two expensive bits of software. Okay, so guys, here it goes. What can we do now for ourselves? Well, we can go open our browser to this site, glifflc.edu. GLOSS stands for Global Language Online Support System, DLI Defense Language Institute, Foreign Language Center, .edu. Every educational institution in America has a .edu extension. And then, bam, you get, this is your selection. We have materials for all these languages. Okay, already developed, and that are in use every day in military schools, military language schools. We use this stuff every day. We have all these materials. We have it segmented. And you can see, of course, we don't have everything. We do have German, but we don't have Dutch. Sorry, if you want to learn Dutch, you have to go back to the Pimsleur guy.
Am I missing Mandarin? Oh, Chinese Mandarin.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, so we have that. Portuguese, notice it's Brazilian rather than European. That's more important to the Department of Defense. French is a very, very big language. Not because it's European, because it's African. And all the operations that go on in Africa. So it's very, and of course languages you expect, Russian, of course, Spanish, of course, what else, Japanese, of course. Japanese was one of the first ones the United States did because it started right after, or maybe even during World War II. So of course we want to train soldiers in Japanese, do intelligence work with it. And a lot of the soldiers I trained personally were going into intelligence, and I thought this was a scream because I'm training them to do intelligence work and I'm totally unemployable in this field because of my family background. I have two citizenships, two and a half almost. So that's a no-go there. But I can train people to do that work. So there's selections, that's what you get. Okay. So now we have to teach you about something called ILR, which is short for Interagency Language Roundtable. This is a scheme that the United States government has come up with. Well, all agencies use it, defense, FBI, whoever needs linguists, Army, Navy, Marines, they all use this ILR scheme. It goes like this. It's basically 1 to 4, but that's theoretical. Okay, one is that you can say a simple sentence. Hi, I'm fine. My name is John. Okay? Okay, that's level one. One plus, hi, my name's John. What's your name? How do you feel? You know, something. One is ping pong. One simple sentences on none. Okay, so we go up the scale. Level two, newspaper kind of thing. You should be able to read in your language that you're studying. The Attorney General has had to resign because he's had a connection with Russia, and blah, blah, blah. Okay, that's level two, that you can read that. 2+, you can say, and this indicates possible problems, possible intelligence leak, something a little more advanced. Okay, level three. Oh, what does this mean? For instance, the last presidential election, the Democrats lost the election. Can you give me an analysis? Why did they lose the election? Do they have another strategy to do better in the next election? That's level three. Okay? And level three, we are talking about paragraphs. You speak in paragraphs. It's discourse. Paragraphs. Level four, you get to talk about ecological things in a very specialized way. You know, for instance, how is the Fukushima reactor accident influencing the fish life on the Pacific coast, off the California coast, and what are the prospects for amelioration? You're talking at level four. This is, you'll be on national television and you're an expert in your field. You probably have a PhD at that level in your language. And we don't get to level four. We get to level three. We're really good at DLI. Requirements, native teachers, level three. I got level three in Chinese. Level two in English. They only had to be at level two to teach, to be a professor there in English. And of course, level three in their native language. Okay, so that's ILR, that's the United States government has adopted. That's what, why you have to know this, because the materials, you're gonna make a selection what you need. Okay, the next thing you will see they want you to do when you select one of those languages to study, they want modality. Modality just means, do I practice listening? Do I practice reading? Okay? There'll be listening and reading exercise. Sometimes you combine the both. Like, you'll listen to a newscast. Listen, I don't get it. Then I'll look at the text. Then I'll go back and listen. And this is the real technique for learning the language. Listen. Don't get it. Go back to the text. Still don't get the text. Look up the words that you don't know. You got Google Translate. Look up those words one by one. Google Translate will work very well for individual words. Like, I can tell you what matrix algebra is. But if you translate a segment, a love letter, then you're in deep trouble because it'll make it almost laughable. But on the granular level, it's okay. It's really good. But of course, you wouldn't want to rely on it for translating a contract. You better find somebody really competent. Okay, this one I don't know. Select a topic, then it'll have topics. Like, you can study culture, economic, environment, geography, military, blah, 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 tech, all these things. These are the choices you'll have. And then you have an advanced search on ticket box, if you have remember the choice you made, and they limit your selection. Let's go to this. Do I hit escape, break out of here in a second? Let's do this. If you can't remember the stuff that I taught you, how to find that URL, it's always like this, DLI gloss. Okay, bingo, it's the first one. Online support system. Okay, this is the page, it comes up. Okay, so, I mean, I don't quite dare to show you guys Chinese because I don't want you to freak out, but maybe French, because people have taught French here and maybe more familiar. So it's level. Okay, so let's start with something stupidly easy. One. Now you notice, I didn't do anything with this modality. I didn't do this competence. I didn't do anything here, all this stuff, because I want the broadest selection of materials at level one. So that's why I did that. And blah, blah, blah. And bingo, I have 37 lessons I can choose from. Bingo. Okay. Here we go. This is probably a reading selection. A full French meal. I don't know if I should show you this, guys, whether you're going to want to go to a French restaurant immediately. Let's go a new house, because you got something to hear, and everybody likes houses. So here, they give you a lesson that you do yourself. This is the objective. You know, teachers always have to have objectives. The description, bingo, we begin the lesson. And they begin, they show you pictures. They love pictures. Two steps, following steps one and two, blah, 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 go ahead. Yeah, and you understand, you're getting the directions how to do this in French. Everybody with me on how to do this? Right, nothing
what,
to it.
What terms?
Or expressions.
On the images.
Are suggested to you by these images. And by the title of the lesson. And then write them in the box below. So you do this, your little lesson.
How do you know, and you don't speak French, how do you know?
Right, like it starts right off in French.
Well, that's our system.
You go look it up.
You look it up, yeah. You just cut paste, Google Translate, right? Can I do that? Can I do? Okay, Control C, Google Translate. Leave, I'm coming back, huh, baby? I gotta hit French. French. Control V. Bingo. Okay?
Oh, benefits, okay. What terms are subjects?
Blah, blah, blah. Okay? But I'm a language teacher. I never speak English in class. That's the last thing I'm going to do. I mean, even I wouldn't even let the students say, can I go to the bathroom? You have to learn it in the language that we're teaching you if you want to get there successfully. I mean, just forget the English when you come in the classroom. It doesn't exist. Unless there are made up words, like in French, like they ask you, you're an IT guy, and I say, hey, savez-vous the troubleshooting? You know how to do troubleshooting with the computer. That's okay, because that comes into French anyway. Just like we have French words in our language, pièce de résistance and all this stuff. Okay, so that's how you operate. And this, by the way, is called immersion. Okay, the successful language student goes to immersion, the immersion approach. There is no grammar translation, there is no drill to kill and all this stuff. We don't do it. It's old stuff, old school. We don't do it anymore. It wasn't that useful.
So can you listen to how they're speaking?
Absolutely, Gilby. Absolutely. There are lessons.
Chance to speak back?
No, don't have a chance to speak back because we don't have that facility here. But you can listen. And if you want to speak back, you got to spend some money. You got to go buy yourself, Dragon Naturally Speaking. Or there's one that I've got on this thing, but it doesn't work that well. You speak, let's say in French, moi je suis aveugle, aujourd'hui c'est un peu froid, mais, you know, something like that. So if what you said resolves into French, in other words, you see the French being typed out, you're good.
Oh.
You're good to go. If it doesn't resolve and there's no printing coming out, you failed. It's that simple. That's Dragon Naturally Speak. I have another one here, but it doesn't work that well, a free one. Okay, so we soldier on. That was the new house. Where were we? And you should get some of the audio here. Begin lesson. Blah, 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 we did this. Let's go on to this. We said we did this and it's good. Compare. I'll just compare and I'll fail everything. Okay, some relevant terms should be agent immobilier.
Oh, so they give you some suggestions.
Right,
okay.
Right. That you should be knowing here. Chambre à coucher, salle à manger, blah, 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 cuisine, salle de bain, jardin, and blah, blah, blah. Everybody knows. Nothing to it. Okay. And then go on here.
Where did you pull that up from, Raj?
I did compare.
Oh, compare. Okay.
And it did
put
this stuff up there for me. Mm-hmm. I was supposed to put some of these keywords into this box, but I just showed it fast and did nothing, and I couldn't find the jardin. Like this is, God knows, this could be salle à manger, I don't know. No, maybe it's chambre à coucher for all I know.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like it could be, but no bed in the place.
Mm-hmm.
Wouldn't that be my luck? Okay, so. So next, then we can do some listening.
Monsieur et Madame Durand?
Oui, bonjour. Je suis Jacques Durand et voici mon épouse Elisabeth. Nous venons visiter la maison.
Okay. This is on a telephone. It's rather early. Communication's bad. We do this to soldiers all the time. because we make them suffer.
Because that's the
field. Yeah, it's a field. If you're going in the field, don't expect studio conditions. Not going to happen. So this is somebody calling an agent and asking to be shown a house. So it's always going to be a situation. Yep.
Is there any way to read what you're listening to?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay.
There's going to be a text. We're going to be, bingo, source. And that's what we just heard. Okay? We just heard that. There's a source for you. Okay? So we took care of that for you.
But you're saying a technique for somebody in immersion would be to listen and try to listen again, then
right.
Try to listen one more time, and then read the text.
No, you can listen once. I'm so fed up. I'm upset. I'm going to look at the text.
Oh, okay.
You know, that's
but then
yours.
Listen again.
And then listen again. And then listen until I don't need the text.
Right.
I can throw the text away.
Okay.
I got it. Okay, that's the
as
text.
As much as you want.
Yeah, and remember, folks, learning is an individual thing. Okay, so some people have to listen 25 times, some people 10, some people 50. The question is, do you want this language? Okay, and if you're like some people, I'm going to be dropped behind enemy lines, and this, my life depends on it, you bet I want it. Like nothing else, I want to stay alive. So, you know, there aren't the school rules, okay? All's fair in love and war. So that's pretty much a lesson as it goes. I don't know where I can go. Three, what was this? There'll be some questions about, oh, now comes listen to the audio segment. And select all, we just heard the audio segment, I can play it one more time, and then you have to answer these questions.
À droite, le salon donnant sur la terrasse, il est beaucoup plus ensoleillé que le nôtre.
J'aime bien la cheminée aussi.
Passons maintenant dans la salle à manger, elle est spacieuse et a un haut plafond.
Pouvons-nous regarder la cuisine?
Certainement. Vous verrez qu'elle est très moderne et bien équipée.
Okay, so now it asks you questions about what you heard. And I heard la salle à manger, c'est spacieuse, so has plenty of space. That's one of the things I heard. Okay, so we got that. So you do this, you do your exercise, it'll check you whether you're good. I'm not sure about this one. Doing is right, but does not. Maybe. The dining room has high ceiling. Kitchen needs new appliances. I'm not sure about that one. Okay, then here. How did I do? Okay, here it tells you. Bless the blah, blah, blah. Okay, there are human. Wait, false. True, false. Blah, blah, blah. You do this. Très bien, c'est annoncé et vrai. Your choice is good. Blah, 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 the bedroom is, look, honey, all the closets and doors are brand new, blah, 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 so you can rehear it.
C'est une chambre est jolie. Regarde ma chérie. Tous les placards et les portes sont neufs.
Okay, so in here, c'est chambre est jolie. Regarde ma chérie, look, darling. Tous les placards et les portes sont neufs. All the window trimmings and the are new. Yeah. So, and then here we give you a little grammar, but we don't beat you over the head with it. Sit is a singular feminine demonstrative. Blah blah blah. Okay. By this time, you should have gotten picked it up. So, this is. Pretty much, oh, we're not doing so well here on time. Okay, I'm going to cut back on this, leave. So you see how this gloss works. I'm going to go back to my PPT a minute here. And we're going from current slide, I do this. Okay, so we do, this is how to navigate this gloss system, this language tool for teaching yourself. So I think you're good with that. Okay, what's the difference, my summit, between these materials, the school's materials, the Pimsleur materials, what's the difference? Well, as I said, you pay at the office, comes out, this is paid for already, you already paid through your tax dollars. Site use communicative approach. I'm always going to have a real life scenario. I'm looking for an apartment. Tell me a little bit about this apartment on the phone. You know, real life. And you have to get things right. You're motivated because, gosh, if a woman tells me my plane is, the gate has been changed from 45 to 46, I want to get on that plane and not be charged an extra fee. So I better understand what she's saying to me. They're authentic, from real life, no drill to kill, we told you that. The exercises, after all, are somewhat entertaining. And the big thing for adults, you learn autonomously. Okay, you're in charge, okay? You manage your time, and this has to do with my philosophy, and I think most people at TLI would say, we don't know how to teach language. It's impossible to teach. You learn it. Well, I'll be your coach, okay? I'll be your facilitator, but you are going to teach yourself the language. And that's the philosophy that I find works the best. And okay, so where do we go? You get your hands dirty, select the language, start learning. Oh, then if you learned your French in school, you had 3 years, you can go back here to diagnostic assessment and test your French. And at the end of the test, it'll say, you know what? Yeah, you had it 3 years in school, but you're only at level one. You didn't even make it to level two. So then you know, okay, I got to start back at level one. They said, oh yeah, you were quite successful. You're on level two. Go on from there. Go from level two. Go to the level. So in the tool that I had for selecting the materials, that was there. And so you can right away go, fit where you can apply your efforts where they're going to bear fruit. And you can.